All right, what's going on, y'all? Welcome back to Final Fantasy 16. Let's jump back into this thing. Let's do this. All right, speak with Wade. Lazarus District.
You're telling me that's the Archduke's son?
In the flesh.
Tell us then, Sir Wade. What is your plan?
Nothing fancy. You, Lady Jill, and I make for Buett Bridge and provoke the main host at their encampment. Sensing an opportunity to end the Guardians, the Black Shields will call for reinforcements, who will be met from the rear by parties of my brothers hidden throughout the surrounding hills. This will allow us to wage battle on the bridge without fear of being overwhelmed. While the Black Shields have an advantage in numbers, you see, they prefer to fight in small units, which we can use to our advantage.
How small exactly?
Small enough, now that I have you and Lady Jill for company. I doubt I could have done this on my own.
But until we arrived, that was your plan. You haven't changed a bit.
Sir Wade, the bearers from Old Hill have been laid to rest.
Very good.
Now make ready for battle.
As you command.
Thank you, Sir Wade. Perhaps now they will find peace.
There is but one thing which will grant them peace. Putting an end to the Black Shields.
And so we shall.
Cool. Accept the quest, black or white. Throughout the main scenario, Clive will often be joined by various companions who are keen to lend their assistance. However, depending on Clive's destination, they may choose to remain behind at the highway. Okay. Confront the Black Shield's main host. Make for Bwip Bridge. All right.
May the blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
How long have you been pursuing the Black Shields?
Since they burned their first village. We tracked down the bastards responsible and fed their corpses to Stillwind. Suffice to say, that got their attention. It's been a game of cat and mouse ever since.
Okay. Quiet Sands.
Look at me sideways.
Come along now.
Bastards are lucky I did that.
There they are. On your command, my lord.
Let's do this thing.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Viceroy. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For
Azaria! Let's go. Let's go for the mages first. There we go. Oh my god, we're turning up right now. Oh yeah, lit.
Bloody hell. Reinforcements from the far bank.
Good with me. There we go. Imperial War Wyvern. Dude, we are so overpowered, it's actually unreal. New enemies approach. Come on. And we got it. my lord. Easy money.
A noble stand, albeit a misguided one. In taking it, you have but proven our point, that this land is in dire need of cleansing.
Okay. Let's go, let's go. Let's do this thing. Come on. Knight of the Last and Dark is getting torn to shreds right now. Slain. Good stuff.
I don't see any more.
Nor do I. The plan worked.
It did. It bloody worked. We sent every last one of the rotten bastards straight to the mud! My, Lord, perhaps this will be enough to stop the Cullings. For the time being, at least.
Perhaps. Though I doubt my mother will take this loss well. She'll move swiftly to see her minions' ranks replenished.
And then it will all begin again. I often wonder if the nation we once knew is gone for good. Her fields rot. Her people starve. We battle to preserve the flame that was, but for every foe we fell, another springs up in its place. Yet be that as it may, it is still our home, and we must fight for it. As we always have, and always will. For as long as the Firebird's flame burns in our hearts, the Duchy cannot die. And her loyal subjects may dream of a day when the Rosarian standard flies over Rosalith once more.
So wait,
think we should fall back to Port Isolde before the garrison sends reinforcements? A sound strategy, my lord.
Quest complete. There we go.
And how long has my uncle been funding you and your comrades' endeavors?
Since the beginning. Lord Byron was the first person I turned to after forming the Guardians. And had I known of this tunnel back then, I wouldn't almost have been hanged by the city guard for trying to sneak over the wall.
I suppose a formal request for an audience would have appeared suspicious.
And appearances must be maintained. Were the Vice Regency to catch wind of Lord Byron's involvement in our movement, they'd seize his estate and send him to the gallows, where he would be of no use to anyone. And so, though it sickens him to the soul, He plays the part of the loyal lord, knowing that one wrong move might prove his downfall. It is why he remains ever vigilant. Don't be surprised if he refuses you an audience, especially since you're famously dead.
Then I will have to think of a way to prove that I am neither wraith nor wrongdoer.
I might have something which could help with the latter. It's the mark of the Guardians. Display it, and those who love Rosaria will know where your loyalties lie.
Okay. Accept the burnt blade from Wade. Kind of rhymed.
Wear it with pride.
Be sure that you do. I don't want my men attacking you again. Unless you deserve it. If only Sir Tyler could have been here to see you. Or the Lord Commander.
Thank you, Sir Wade. If there is ever anything you need.
I know. Go on now, my lord.
How accommodating. Do you really think they believe we are who we say we are?
Not a chance. Right, I guess. My uncle believes we're imposters here to rob him. And means to string us up himself.
Imagine my surprise when I was told my nephew had come to visit. Clive Rosfield died long ago. And for uttering his name here, you shall pay with your tongue! You would mock me as well.
It is I, Sir Crandall of Camelot, loyal servant to Her Serene Holiness, Saint Sybil the Unshod. Murdo, thou vile sorcerer, for thy crimes against church and crown, I shall have thy head.
Curse thee, infectious flax wench. Even in death, must thou plague me still? Very well. I shall open the gates of hell, that thou might see thy charge once more.
Bravo, uncle. You're still the finest Maddo in the Twins.
Oh, Clive, my dear boy, it's really you. You always were fond of that scene from The Saint and the Sanctuary. Never did let me play Sir Crandall.
I have a favor to ask, Uncle Byron.
Rutherford, inform the kitchens. There'll be guests. We dine immediately.
But, Uncle...
You can't very well regale me with the tale of your miraculous preservation on an empty stomach. Go on, sit. See that you use the good plates, Rutherford.
So you arrived late to one of her cullings, did you? Since becoming Vicerine, Annabella has been a constant thorn in Rosaria's side, but these atrocities are a new low. Something has changed. Quite what? I don't know, but the woman we knew is gone, and a monster sits in her place.
A monster?
For better or worse, I've been charged with governing this town, and thus must maintain the illusion of obedience. That's all I can do to aid Wade and his merry band of revolutionaries.
So he's told us. You have risked much for Rosaria. Our nation will be forever in your debt.
It has been 20 years, Clive. The nation your father and your forefathers fought to defend is no more. Perhaps it would be otherwise had I the courage of my brother. All right, if it's a ship you require, a ship you shall have. I've a galley in port, but recently relieved of her cargo. She can be outfitted for the voyage in a matter of weeks.
So you believe us, then? About everything?
Believe you? Ha! Only a fool would believe even half of the things you claim. But until tonight, only a fool would have believed my nephew still lived. And besides, I have it on good authority that Clive is telling the truth.
Whose authority?
By your own, of course. You've always been a terrible liar.
Is that true?
It's not untrue.
Let's say no more about it, eh? It wouldn't do to linger on my nephew's greatest failing. The one thing I cannot believe, though, is all this about you being Cid. You were always such a good boy, but now you're quite the outlaw. Which, if I'm not mistaken, would make me an outlaw's uncle. Right then, who shall we pillage first? Rutherford, fetch me my cutlass. This will be fun.
She's a fine ship, isn't she? Once outfitted, she'll bear us across the boiling sea to Drustanus in the space of 3 days. Something on your mind?
Monsters. When I served the Iron Kingdom, I did so because I saw no other choice. Because once they learned that Lash would not move me, they turned it on those who could. And so I became their puppet. I let them pull my strings, telling myself it was not my hand that swung the sword, but another's. I removed myself from the truth so I wouldn't feel the pain it caused. And before I knew it, I no longer felt anything. Anything at all. I had become a monster.
Jill.
I don't want to be a monster, Clive. Do you understand? I want to choose a different path, a better path. To live on my own terms. But before I can do that, I need to come to terms with my past.
And when you do, I'll be standing there with you, just as you stood with me.
Thank you, Clive. I must atone for my sins. Only then, when it's done, will the monster cease to be.
Just promise me that you won't die with it. Now, let's get some sleep. The journey back to Benamir is long, and there is much to tell the others.
Okay, return to the hideaway. Here be monsters.
Only the Founder knows what awaits us in the Iron Kingdom. But Vivian could probably make an educated guess.
Okay.
Typical nobles.
Back again, Lord Rosfield. I'm touched that you should find me such good company.
It is not your company, but your counsel that I seek on this occasion.
Ah, ever the charmer. What will it be today, then?
The Iron Kingdom. I need to know what to expect.
You'll soon be setting sail for Drake's Breath, then, I take it. The Mother Crystal that rises from the boiling sea. There was a time when a true-blooded Rosarian had only to brave the waves to visit it. But then the Ironblood made their move. As you know, the Iron Kingdom rules over the islands to the west of Storm. Or rather, its church does. But this is not the pragmatic approach to state religion employed by the Holy Empire to manipulate the masses. No. The Iron Kingdom is the literal embodiment of the crystalline orthodoxy. And so, if one is to understand it, one must start there. As the name implies, the orthodoxy holds the Mother Crystal sacred, and they do not take kindly to heathens plundering the objects of their worship for the means to fill washtubs and light lamps with frivolous feats of magic. Indeed, the faithful consider ether a sinful thing. A poison, no less. And to them, a dominant is an instrument of evil, albeit one they have proven only too happy to turn against their enemies. Some 80 years ago, in Northern Storm, Drake's Eye collapsed. Soon after, in pursuit of Aether, and with the Blight at their backs, the Northern Territories descended upon the Grand Duchy of Rosaria. And when the Shields of the Flame marched north to meet them, the Iron Kingdom spied an opportunity. A few short days later, the Crusaders landed on the island of Mount Drastanus, home of Drake's Breath, and plucked it from the Duchy's grasp. Rosaria tried to reclaim it, of course, but to no avail. I doubt more than a handful of Duchy men have set foot on its shores in your lifetime. Nor are they like to again, under the Empire's stewardship. Meaning the Iron Blood will keep their island, and with it, the foothold they need to march on mainland soil when next they spy an opportunity. The The Mother Crystal is both the object of the Iron Blood's worship and their gateway to the continent, making Drustanus the holiest of holy grounds, from which the Orthodox Crusade shall one day sail forth to claim the remaining Mother Crystals, or die trying.
My father and my grandfather both traded blows with the Iron Blood for control of Drek's Breath. Had things unfolded differently at Phoenix Gate, we would have sent our entire fleet against them.
But instead, they sent their fleet against Rosaria, sacked the capital, killed the men, and captured the women, including Jill. I'd say you'd be forgiven for wanting a little revenge, Clive.
My only aim is to destroy the Mother Crystal. But thank you all the same. Not much else to do here. Let's see if Jill's ready.
Okay, go speak to Jill.
It will be over soon.
You ready?
I think so.
Jill, when you told me you had to come to terms with your past, you weren't talking about destroying Drek's Breath, were you?
No. I spoke of Imran, the leader of the Crystalline Orthodox, the man who made me do all those unspeakable things. I'm going to kill him. It's what I need to do to put the past behind me. What I need to move forward. And I know that I can do it. If you're there beside me.
Always.
And I'll be beside you, too. We'll bring down the Mother Crystal together. All while Cid looks on.
We'll make him proud.
Okay. Drake's Breath. Here we go.
Useful trick. Freezing and thawing the spray to make mist. How did you learn to use your powers like this?
The Masters made me do it when the Crusaders took to the seas to keep the fleet's movements from prying eyes. I'm fine.
No, you're not.
This may be the only chance I get to go back. My only chance to put things right. I have to do this. Whatever the cost.
All right.
She is. The Iron Kingdom's Mother Crystal.
Drake's Breath. Strong currents, sharp rocks, and ether floods. Let's not forget them. This island is a natural fortress.
But safety breeds complacency, allowing a single rowing boat to slip in unseen. The sanctuary is inside the mountain. If we follow the old trail, we should be able to enter by the back gate.
All right. Let's go.
Okay, fire and ice.
I always imagined when I came here it would be to reclaim it.
It used to belong to Rosaria, didn't it?
Once, though it's been in the Ironblood's clutches for far too long.
As was I. For 13 years, this rock was my home. I know its secrets only too well. This path was abandoned after an ether flood. They don't guard it anymore.
The perfect little shortcut.
Okay. Yep, more Akashic. Here we go. Let me... Can I upgrade? Not yet. Okay. Probably do... Yeah, upgrade that next. It'll be good. Nice. Perfect.
Was that an earthquake?
They happen all the time. That wasn't even a bad one. It's nothing to worry about.
Take them out. Cool. Oh, I see him right there. Okay. Minotaur. Let's go. Go again. Alright, got him halfway. Let's go, let's go. Crazy. Nice.
The old arboretum is just up there. We'll enter the caves from there.
Okay. Let me see if I can. Okay, yeah, we got enough. I'm gonna do this right here. Before the thunderstorm it rains multiple. Okay. Upgraded. Perfect. And we'll do, I guess there was more of that we could have done, but it's okay, we'll do that next then. Pile drive. That's also lit. Okay. Just gotta upgrade this. Okay. We got a lot of stuff. Open this up.
Look at this place. What a mess.
Wait.
It's turned.
Nothing a Shield of Rosaria can't handle.
Oh great, another one. Okay, except this one's a Sheik. A Sheik Morvel. Let's go. Go crazy. Come on. Staggered. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Stop running away from me. What are you doing? Go crazy. Almost. Almost got him, almost got him. There we go. Akashic Morble slain.
press on?
Yes.
Okay.
It's like a furnace in here.
We're inside the volcano. You get used to the heat. Though I don't remember it being this hot.
Was that one cause for concern?
It was. And they're getting bigger. Something's wrong.
Scarlet scorpions? Go. Salamander? Okay, that's not what a salamander looks like, but I guess that's what this one does. Turn him up. Go, 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 go. There you go, staggered. Let's go.
Fuck. Is there no other way across?
Guess not.
Do that again.
No. Let's not.
I was lit. I was like, Jill's got ice and stuff like that. I was like, I'm pretty sure she handled this. Sure enough, I was right. What are those things? The giant vault? And no, I mean, she, no, Birch can't kill him. Don't even want to think about what they are. A bomb. Okay. Self-explanatory. Come on. Torched alive.
Well, we aren't going this way.
Let's look for another path.
All right.
Drake's breath.
We're nearly at the oratory.
Looks crazy. Oh, what the? I don't even know, Clive. I me neither, Jill. What is this? It's like, okay. It's got a mouth. It looks like jello. And it's got tentacles. You know what? I'm just going to kill this thing. This thing cannot be friendly. You know, some things you just know. This is one of them. Red moose? Okay. Fire Aga, okay. He's got that equipped too. This thing. Okay. But turn me up, I guess. Flame lizard. We're doing damage. There we go. Staggered. Big damage. Almost got him halfway. Ah!
There we go, now he's past halfway.
What's it doing?
Nothing good, I'll wager.
There we go. Door thing. Let's go. Go turn me up. Good stuff. Come on, come on. Enough. There we go, got him. Flame Lizard slain.
Thank you.
Quite a commotion our friend made. Let's hope the guards didn't hear it.
The gate to the inner chambers is just up there. Then we make for the sanctuary. I need to finish this before the heat finishes me.
Hear, hear.
Okay.
We'll enter the Comrick by the Handmaiden's living quarters. It was always a hive of activity.
Sounds like we'll have a hard time staying out of sight.
We won't have to. There's someone there I should very much like to see.
Through here. All right, I might pause it here, actually. This is a good place to pause. I'll do this. Upgrade that. Cool. Oh, that's fully maxed out. Cool. W. Well, there you have it. Cool. All right. Well, I will save here. And I will see y'all in the next part. All right. Peace.